Hey there. So I often get asked to talk a bit about the Tale of Two Selves. So I first learned about the term a Tale of Two Selves from one of my favorite teachers, Robert Holden. And what it really talks about is the fact that we all have these two selves. Now I know for myself, there are a lot more voices than two in this head of mine, as you might be feeling as well. But this in modern psychology really speaks to two very specific versions of ourself that we carry with us always. So there is what is known as the unconditioned self. This is the self that we brought into this world. You know, as you're a newborn baby, you are unconditioned. You know, it's also known as the true self. It is known in Christianity as the original blessing. In Buddhism, the original face. And in many wisdom traditions, in many religions, even in yoga, it's known as the highest self. I prefer to think of it as the deepest self, because if I think of highest self, then it's like above me and I'm not sure I can, you know, get to it. I've got to reach for it. But if it's my deepest self, then I know it's always there inside me, waiting, just waiting to be unveiled, waiting to be tapped into as a source of energy and wisdom. But it's this unconditioned self that we bring into the world. And when you look at a small baby, a small baby does not doubt, does not hold grudges, does not have any reason to be angry or cynical, because they haven't been conditioned by life circumstances yet. But then ultimately in our lives as humans, what happens is well, life happens. And whether it's through a variety of, you know, grievances, we at one point, often too young in life, have that first betrayal, we're told the first lie, we're told the first stories of what our limits are and what our capabilities are. We start to tell ourselves stories about what our limits and capabilities are, or in what way, shape, or form we feel like we are not enough. And so we start to form what is called the conditioned self. This is also known as the personality, the ego, the Facebook profile. This is the also known in more modern day psychology as the invented self, because this is the version of ourself that we create to put out into the world. Once we've had a certain level of life experiences and circumstances that we are now, you know, reacting to, we start to create another version of ourselves. We put it out into the world in hopes of receiving some form of validation and or acceptance. And how one of my favorite teachers and authors, Marianne Williamson, so beautifully teaches in her book, A Return to Love, which is based on The Course in Miracles. Life is really about coming back around to that unconditioned self, tapping back into that unconditioned self, the self that is not reacting to circumstances, the self that is not on the constant search for happiness, because it's that unconditioned self. It's already happy. It already is accepting. It doesn't, you know, doubt who you are and what you're capable of. It hasn't formed any levels of cynicism or held on to any grudges. It never even formed any grudges to begin with to be able to hold on to. All of that comes through the kind of external version of ourselves, that that created conditioned self that we really build along the way. And my hope for you is that you just each day take some deep breaths as you are moving through life and on your journey, on your path, and just see where there may be opportunities to tune back in, to tune back in, to tap back into your unconditioned self, to who you really are, to your true self, to your deepest self. Because what I have most certainly learned along the way is that there is a great deal of energy and strength and wisdom living within that version of you. So, good luck. Much love to you always. Mwah.